This is ESPN on ABC, brought to you in part by Samsung QLED TV, the official TV of ESPN College Football.
Welcome, everyone, to AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, where this championship Saturday of college football begins with the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship. The Oklahoma Sooners taking the field, ranked number 10 against the Iowa State Cyclones. They are the number 6 team in the country. This is the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Football Championship game on ABC, part of Dr. Pepper Championship Week. Oklahoma trying to win its 14th conference title in 25 years, while Brock Purdy and Iowa State trying to win their first. It's the Cyclones' first appearance ever in this conference championship game. Hi, everybody, and welcome. Sean McDonough along with Todd Blackledge. Delighted to have you with us. We'll be joined shortly by Todd McShay and Allison Williams. Certainly dramatically different histories for these two football programs. But here in this season, they are very even. We saw that in the regular season matchup, a classic, won by a touchdown by Iowa State. Lincoln Riley, the Oklahoma coach, says they might not have a great history, but this team has a lot of very talented Iowa State players. Not a team full of Rudies, as he said.
Absolutely. You think, I mean, they've got 9 first-team all-conference players, more than any other school, and that includes the offensive player of the year and the nation's leading rusher in Breece Hall, and the defensive player of the year, linebacker Mike Rose, a very veteran, savvy, and talented team.
Outstanding quarterbacks on each side, both hail from the Phoenix, Arizona area, and both Brock Purdy and Spencer Rattler played very well in that epic regular season matchup.
And I think the game comes down to them again in this one. I think ball security, who takes care of the football, but also which one of these two guys can make the most plays off schedule. They're both dynamic. They both have the ability to scramble, extend plays, and also run. It'll come down to which one of those two guys does that the most.
We have about 19,000 fans in attendance here at AT&T Stadium. Iowa State trying to win its first conference championship since 1912.
You're watching Dr. Pepper Championship Week.
This is a special presentation of ESPN, home of the college football playoff, semifinals on New Year's Day.
We are ready to go. Settle in for a great day of college football. Conference championship games, Iowa State hopeful of getting into the college football playoff. They're ranked number 6. They need a win today to remain in the conversation. The Cyclones won the toss and deferred, so Drake Nettles kicks off. And that's not a great start for Iowa State. It goes out of bounds. So it'll be excellent field position for Oklahoma, led by Spencer Rattler. He's had an excellent redshirt freshman season. Best in the Big 12 in completion percentage at 69%. He also leads the conference in passing yards with more than 2,500. And he's thrown 24 touchdown passes. 6'1", 205 pounds, 20 years old. Both he and Brock Purdy can hurt you with their arm and with their feet. And he leads all freshmen nationally in passing yards per game, touchdowns, and yards per pass attempt. With the kickoff out of bounds, the Sooners begin from the 35. Ramondre Stevenson for 3, taken down by Ashim Young, a star position player in this 3-3-5. Cyclones defensive alignment.
Well, you mentioned a different team with Oklahoma. One of the biggest differences, the guy who just carried that ball didn't gain very many yards, but Ramondre Stevenson had to sit out the first 5 games. He's a veteran guy, big, fast back, has changed the running game for Oklahoma.
After the play fake, on target is Rattler to Drake Stoops. There's a late flag that flies in after Stoops hit the ground at the 49-yard line of Iowa State. Ashim Young there again for ISU. David Alvarez leading our Big 12 officiating crew today.
Little RPO fake by Spencer Rattler. It was a shoulder hit by Ashim Young, not a helmet hit. Still taking a look at that though.
Well,
Personal foul. Targeting. Defense. Number one. 15-yard penalty. An automatic first down. The previous play is under review.
So it'll go to Gene Semko, the replay official. Let's bring in our rules expert, Matt Austin. Obviously a very important play here, Matt, less than a minute into the game.
Yeah, this is going to be unfortunate, I'm afraid. The defender, I think, is just trying to make a play, but he does come in hard. He lowers that shoulder. He hits the receiver in the back of the head with the shoulder. He is defenseless, so anything to the head neck area is targeting. So I think this is going to be confirmed, and one's going to be disqualified.
Well, it looks a lot worse from some angles than it does from others. Matt Campbell, the head coach of the Cyclones, very upset. That's John Haycock. You saw in the huddle there a moment ago, their defensive coordinator. But this is an important player.
No doubt.
He was the co-Big 12 defensive freshman of the year, Kari Coleman of TCU. He's from Philadelphia. And they have excelled on defense, and Matt Campbell's the first state, largely because they've played with the same 11 people just about all season long. They've avoided COVID and they've stayed injury free.
Well, Isheem Young was the guy who sealed the win in Ames against Oklahoma, had the interception off of Spencer Rattler late, also had 7 tackles in that game, 5 tackles and a forced fumble against Texas. He would be a huge loss to this defense.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Number one is disqualified.
Well, you have to feel terrible for him. I don't think there is anything malicious about it, but as Matt Austin explained, by the rules, the letter of the law, that is the right call.
I mean, I get it, but this is a hard game. Football is a hard game. That's a hard hit, it's a hard game, and that's a hard call going against Iowa State. I don't like it.
That's not
football. I
just
don't like it.
What he did is a part of football. That's not what they're trying to get out of the
game. That's football.
He didn't lead with his helmet. He didn't launch himself head first. He lowered his shoulder to hit him with his shoulder.
I actually agree with him.
Ramondre Stevenson on first and 10. The penalty took the ball down to the 34-yard line of Iowa State. 1 yard for Stevenson, who's played in the last 4. They've won 6 straight since that loss in Ames back in early October. That was the first win for Iowa State against Oklahoma in Ames since 1960. They had lost 24 straight at home to the Sooners.
Well, Arnold Azuna, number 4, is the guy who's in now at that safety position.
He's a 5th-year senior. Rattler on the run. That's what both quarterbacks can do. Scramble out of the pocket and make big plays down the field. That one's to Jeremiah Hall, one of the 3 Sooners who is first team All Big 12 this year.
Yeah, this is exactly what Coach Haycock was worried about with Spencer Rattler. His ability to extend plays, keep his eyes downfield, and then flick the football for big plays. Jeremiah Hall, a very valuable part of this offensive football team, just moving with his quarterback.
And they line him up all over the place, running back, slot receiver. Here's Stevenson inside the 5, and it'll be first and goal for Oklahoma at the 2. Lawrence White made the stop. And just to go back to the departure of Isheem Young, if that is the rule, they need to change the rule. Yeah, he's making a football play. I'm glad to know that Matt Austin said he agreed. So it's Stevenson again. Powerful, but also quick. They stack him up for nothing. Jake Hummel, one of the seniors on that defense. What a transformation they've watched in their program.
Well, this is one of the areas where Iowa State has been outstanding all year. Their goal to go defense. In fact, in the game against Oklahoma and Ames, in their first possession, they got down inside there. A good stop forced a field goal attempt. Here you see the numbers. Only Northwestern has been better on defense.
Here's Chandler Morris into the game, and he runs in for a touchdown. Morris took the snap. 2-yard touchdown run. He's the 3rd string quarterback from right down the street here in Highland Park, Texas.
A Seth McGowan was also in the game. We weren't sure we were going to see him. He was the running back that got the key block as well. So backup running back, third team quarterback, and the Sooners get a touchdown.
And bring Morris in from time to time to run. He's carried it five times this year now and has his second touchdown and likely first touchdown score in this championship game. And a big early development. Just more than 30 seconds into the game, Isheem Young called for targeting, gone for the rest of the game. And the Sooners go the rest of the way to take the early lead. This is the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship game on ABC, part of Dr. Pepper Championship Week. From the home of the Dallas Cowboys, AT&T Stadium, Arlington, Texas. The roof closed, the temperature in the 50s outside. The side doors are open, so we're getting some nice air through the building. The air went out of the building for Iowa State. And Chandler Morris scored the first touchdown of the game after a controversial targeting call. Took one of the Cyclones' best defenders off the field. Gabe Berkich, the kickoff. Kene Nwangu, the fair catch. Here come the Cyclones on offense, and here comes Todd McShay. Hi, Todd.
Hey, Sean. It was interesting to watch that last play before the touchdown. You had Spencer Rattler going off and kind of just grabbing the back of his hamstring, almost selling the fact that he was injured, and then they make the change at the quarterback position. So I ran over the bench to see if he was healthy, and I heard one of the coaches saying, I love the acting skills.
Well, he didn't come out due to injury. And Chandler Morris did his job. So here's Brock Purdy. Junior hands it off to the conference offensive player of the year, Breece Hall. And he gets about nine on the first play from scrimmage for the Cyclones, shoved out by Trey Brown, the cornerback, a second team all-conference player. Brock Purdy making his 32nd career start. Junior from Gilbert, Arizona. 66% completion percentage behind only Spencer Rattler among Big 12 quarterbacks. Nearly 2,300 yards passing. He was the first team all-conference quarterback as selected by the coaches. He's on target with his first throw to their leading receiver, Xavier Hutchinson.
Little tempo right now also by Iowa State after the first down. Good quick start for Brock Purdy.
51st catch of the year for the newcomer Hutchinson, a junior college transfer. Now Hall dumped for a loss by Isaiah Thomas. That defensive front's been tremendous in the late season.
Well, Isaiah Thomas is coming from right in here. Watch the push back into the backfield. The defensive front, we talked about Ramondre Stevenson being back. Ronnie Perkins, number 7, is back on the defensive line, and he has elevated the play of this entire defensive front, and they have been dominant at times here in the last month.
Like the running back Stevenson, Perkins missed the first 5 games due to a suspension from the end of last season. Out of the pistol, room outside for Hall. He's out near the 44, and he's one of those guys who can run inside the tackles and outside the tackles.
Yeah, I really like that about him. He's got the speed to get to the edge, and then he's got the patience and the toughness to run inside.
I would argue he's the best back in college football this year.
He is a Heisman contender on the radar, certainly, of the ESPN.com folks who have an informal poll each week, and he's one of the 10 semifinalists for the Doak Walker Award. He's out of the game right now. Jirel Brock is their third down back. He stays in the block. Purdy got it off. Hutchinson stumbles, and he's short of the first down near the 50-yard line. Looked like he's about 2 yards short. And Matt Campbell with an early decision to make.
We have to punt the football. I mean, it's so early in the game. That's a long 2 yards. We've seen both quarterbacks already show their ability to extend the play, to get out of the pocket and make a throw. That's a skill that both of these guys possess.
That's frustrating, too, because you lead your receiver to yards after catch. That was a perfect throw.
Joe Rivera on the punt, native of Puerto Rico. Moved to the state of Iowa at age 9. Fair catch made by Marvin Mims. Here's Allison Williams.
Well, Sean, another weapon back for Oklahoma that they didn't have at the beginning of the year. Sophomore wide receiver Trajan Bridges back from a suspension following a failed drug test last season, playing in his first game today. And to say he's excited is an understatement. He could not stop smiling in pregames. Now, he has been getting some first team reps throughout the season, alternating between that and scout team reps. But since Wednesday, he's been working with the first teamers in anticipation of him playing today.
Well, he, along with Ramondre Stevenson and Ronnie Perkins, all reported to have tested positive for marijuana prior to their college football semifinal game against LSU. Last year, they missed that game in the start of this season, but Bridges served more time this year. His circumstances were told different, but that was not explained. Spencer Rattler to Ramondre Stevenson. They're out to the 27-yard line with a 14-yard gain. It's a first down.
Neat little play that time. They faked it to Stevenson, then he just delayed for a second at the line and slipped out.
Marvin Mims, talented freshman, his 30th catch of the year.
Watch this now. Stevenson's going to fake here and then pause just for a second. Lincoln Riley, I think, one of the most ingenious offensive guys, very creative. They do a lot of different things. Iowa State has to be aware of all those little things. Stevenson, not just a runner, but an outstanding receiver as well.
Lincoln Riley is the play caller, and widely regarded as one of the very best. A flag down where you'd expect a holding call. Rattler gets close to the first down marker. He might even have it, but that's likely not to be significant. Creed Humphrey, the Big 12 offensive lineman of the year for the second year in a row, got tangled up with Will McDonald.
Offense, number 56, 10-yard penalty. Replay, second down.
Yeah, it's Creed Humphrey, the center, that's going to get called for the holding. Right there in front of the official. And see, this is one of the other things with the pass protection. You say, what's the center doing way out there? They fake play action and pull linemen to make run and pass look the same. So the center actually pulled out, was blocking on the end of the line, and got caught for the hold on that one.
One of the best centers in the country, perhaps the best. Here's Stevenson with some running room. He has the first down, stayed in bounds, and they're going to mark him out just shy of midfield at the Sooners 47-yard line.
Great job by the right guard. Tyrese Robinson, number 52, gets a big block. The right tackle, Adrian Ely. And again, you see what Stevenson has added to this run game. When the season started, they were not a good running football team, and it put a lot of pressure on their young quarterback, Spencer Rattler. They have gotten better and better. Their offensive line has grown, and then Stevenson being back in has helped.
Everyone thinks about the quarterbacks here. Baker Mayfield, Kyler Murray, Jalen Hurts comes in. But the run game is everything to Oklahoma. It sets up everything.
Marked it at the 46. It was a 25-yard gain. Theo Weiss, he's been emerging as a go-to wide receiver in recent games. And a tough run after the catch has the Sooners close to another first down.
Again, that's you talk about the run, Todd. That's faking the counter trap, pulling the backside guard and tackle, showing run, and flipping it out on a wide receiver screen. They try to make everything look the same, and when they're rolling, they are really difficult to defend.
And when you're a linebacker or a safety, and you're having to watch all those things, it's almost impossible to defend.
A fake to Stevenson, Rattler on target. Inside the 40, it's a first down for Marvin Mims. They didn't have any first-team all-conference players on the defensive side. They had two on the offense, the center Humphrey and the running back Hall, and Mims was second-team all-conference.
And Spencer Rattler was honorable mention, which I don't think he was real happy about. He's off to a great start at 6-for-6. Looks very sharp right now.
They're on the move again, leading 7-0 are the Sooners. Rattler retreated through into a crowd, three men around. Jaden Hazelwood, but he came up with the ball. And it's a first down for Oklahoma at the 20.
I can't describe to you how good of a throw this is. Watch him layer it over the linebacker, Hummel, and right in between three defenders, Hazelwood, a big, tall receiver, able to go up and get the ball. But you've got to get it over that linebacker first for your receiver to even have a chance.
That's the third catch for Hazelwood. He was a five-star recruit. He's a sophomore. And he's missed most of this season with a lower body injury. T.J. Pledger, the running back now. They faked it to him. Mims got away. And Lawrence White came to the rescue of Tavon Kyle, the cornerback, who couldn't get Mims down originally.
We just saw that same play the other side, where they pull the backside guard and tackle. They show that that's their bread and butter run play. They fake it and throw it out quickly to the receiver. Everything that Spencer Rattler has thrown from the pocket has been out of his hands quickly.
Lincoln Riley in his fourth year as head coach, trying to win his fourth conference title. Off to a good start. Looked like the snap was mistimed. I think David Alvarez, the referee's ears are still burning. We heard what Matt Campbell said to him during the commercial after the Oklahoma touchdown. He really let the lead official have it.
Full start. Offense. Number 52, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Tyrese Robinson. We are not able to play it for you. It was spicy. You can understand why he's agitated. Matt Campbell just kept saying, that's football. Yeah. And David Alvarez explained, much in the way that Matt Austin did to our audience, why, by the rules, it was targeting.
Well, the fact that he was a defenseless player is really kind of what set it up that way. That was the difference.
Second and 11. 5 minutes to go in the opening quarter. Controlled by Oklahoma. T.J. Pledger, Jr., who was their leading rusher in the two games just prior to Stevenson's return. He ran for more than 100 against both Texas and TCU, but now a backup with Stevenson back. Third down here. A lot of Cyclone fans have made the 10-hour drive from Ames down here to the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. Each school got 4,500 tickets. Rattler throws to the sideline, and it is incomplete. Officials deem that the catch was juggled by Charleston Rambo as he went across the sideline.
Spencer Rattler leaving the pocket, an accurate throw, but there's the little bit of a bobble with his foot on the line, not able to secure the catch. Good effort. There's the foot landing out of bounds anyway. A field goal situation now for Berkich.
One of the best in the country, first team all Big 12. He was one of their three first team all conference players. Casey Kelleher is the snapper. Spencer Jones the holder. And that one is no good. Well, he didn't miss a kick all of last year. The first miss of his entire college career was this season in the game at Ames when they tried a 54-yarder just before the half. And he's been ordinary since then. No good from 36, and it's still a 7-0 lead for the Sooners at the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship.
The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Football Championship game on ABC is brought to you by Ice Cold Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville, and in part by Capital One, what's in your wallet.
Some of the big plays from the regular season meeting between these two teams. Iowa State wins 37-30. First win since 1960 at home against the Sooners after 24 straight losses. Oklahoma had that chance to tie it. Rattler, the late interception. Brock Purdy on target. Nice effort by Xavier Hutchinson, the junior college transfer, was the Big 12 Offensive Newcomer of the Year out of Blinn Junior College here in Texas.
Well, right away on that play, you see one of the advantages that Iowa State has in this game, the size of their receivers and tight ends against the defensive backs of Oklahoma. It's kind of a mismatch all the way across the board.
They play with three tight ends for a high percentage of snaps. They're all huge, and Hutchinson's tall as well. Down the field for one of those tight ends. It's Charlie Kohler, the Norman, Oklahoma native who grew up just a couple of minutes walk from the stadium on the Oklahoma campus.
See, here's Kohler, 6'6", against Pat Fields, a 5'10 safety. And Brock Purdy has so much confidence to throw it up there.
They go quickly, they go to the run, and it's Breece Hall for about 10 more after the 28-yard completion, Purdy to Kohler.
And going back to Kohler, he's smart enough to know that he can use his size. He got a late push, but he did it intelligently. He made sure that the ref didn't see it. He just got that little bit of late separation, and that's why he's so good.
Yeah, uses his body extremely well.
Was a basketball player at Norman North High School, was a high school teammate, in fact, of Trey Young, the great star of the Atlanta Hawks, who played collegiately at Oklahoma. Wasn't recruited to play football by the Sooners. Xavier Hutchinson, he was recruited by Oklahoma. He had already committed to Iowa State when the Sooners expressed their interest in him, and he stuck with his commitment for the Cyclones.
Now, right now, a nice drive going. Brock Purdy very quick with his decision making, where he wants to go with the ball. And Hutchinson, who had a big 65-yard touchdown catch against Oklahoma and Ames, off to a pretty good start.
Four catches already for Hutchinson. The last one good for 8 yards. They're on the move. On first and 10, Hall looked like he might lose some. Got dragged down by Ronnie Perkins after a 2-yard gain.
This is what I think makes Breece Hall really special, his patience. Watch this now as he starts here. You're right, Sean. This looked like a loss of yardage play. But watch him just wait for that block to continue and then get upfield and turns it into a 2-yard gain instead of a 2-yard loss. That's a heck of a run.
Excellent defensive line against a solid Iowa State offensive line. Purdy faked to Hall, got it away under duress, and it's broken up. Intended for Hutchinson and batted down by Trey Brown.
Yeah, really nice play by Trey Brown. He's their best cover guy. The ball hung in the air a little bit because Purdy was throwing it backing up. See how it flutters a little bit? And that enabled Trey Brown to get a hand on it and knock it away.
They blitzed the linebacker, Brian Asamoah. Here's third down and 8. Oklahoma leads 7-0. They scored on the opening drive of the game.
Now, right now, it is 3rd and 8, and they have 13 personnel in the game, which means one back and 3 tight ends. Number 89, Sainer, is a tight end right now in motion.
3 tight ends, all 6'6 or taller. Purdy gets it away, incomplete. Intended for Hutchinson. He couldn't bring it in. And will it be a field goal try? It appears that it will be for Connor Asali, their fifth-year senior, who came to Iowa State as a walk-on and put on scholarship this year in his fifth year. This is from 43. It would be a season-long. His career-long is 50. Of course, indoors with the wind not a factor. Good snap and hold. And that one is no good. Hit the right upright and did not carry him through. So each team has missed a field goal here in the first quarter.
Taco Bell's Nachos Party Pack. Delicious nachos topped with all your favorites. Only at Taco Bell.
Aerial coverage high atop AT&T Stadium, provided by Goodyear. The best part of every kickoff is the drive that comes next. Go further with Goodyear, more driven. Oklahoma took the opening kickoff, started at their 35-yard line. It was a kickoff out of bounds, drove down the field and scored, missed a field goal in their last possession. So this is their third try with the ball, and it's Ramondre Stevenson ahead for about 5. Mike Rose and Orion Vance in on the stop for Iowa State.
Again, that misdirection, you just got to really be on point defensively. They pulled the guard that time, and then they run the option back the other way.
Rattler, an inside handoff. Stevenson went down just shy of the line to make, and we're under a minute to go in the first quarter of this Big 12 title game. John Haycock, veteran defensive coordinator, one-time head coach at Youngstown State. From a football family, his dad was a star player and coached. Two brothers coached in college football. Jim Haycock, longtime defensive coordinator at Ohio State. Mikey Henderson weaving his way through the traffic. Highly recruited freshman who played high school ball right down the street here in Irving, Texas. Might get us to the end of the quarter. They don't have to snap it again. And they will run one more play. Spencer Rattler takes off running, throws on the run, and it is deflected and caught. Marvin Mims made the catch.
Jake Hummel had the interception. I mean, he had both hands on it and just not able to pull it down. And the ball ricocheted off Hummel, and Mims comes up with it. Watch, a tough throw. It's deflected first. I think that was Orion Vance, number 34, that deflected it first, and then Hummel almost caught it.
ESPN's presentation of college football on ABC will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
The journey is on. The AT&T countdown to the College Football Playoff National Championship, Monday, January 11th on ESPN.
We're back in Arlington, Texas. The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship game, end of one quarter. Oklahoma leading Iowa State 7-0.
Mims right here. You got to defend deep shots with Oklahoma.
Rattler looks like he wants to launch one deep. He's going deep for Mims and has the touchdown. Great call by Lincoln Riley and by Todd Blackledge. It's 45 yards.
Well, he runs a tremendous route. It's the perfect time to take this shot, right? Iowa State almost had an interception. He turns a really good player, the safety Greg Eisworth, completely around. And Spencer Rattler hits him with the football. Great route, great call, and the right time after the near interception.
Two Iowa State players got their hands on that throw on the last play of the first quarter. It wound up being a catch to Mims. And the first play of the second quarter is another catch by Mims. Berkich the extra point. Marvin Mims from nearby Frisco, Texas, true freshman, has now set the Oklahoma freshman touchdown reception record all by himself with his eighth of the year. He had shared the record coming in with Mark Andrews, the fine tight end, who caught 7 in 13 games in 2015. CeeDee Lamb in 2017, now starring here with the Cowboys, caught 7 in 14 games. Mims playing in just his 10th game of this season. As we mentioned, this is the start of a great day of championship football on ABC. Coming up next, Clemson and Notre Dame for the ACC championship. The Irish playing in a conference for the first time ever. The American title game, Cincinnati and Tulsa tonight. And the results will have a big impact on the exclusive reveal of the college football playoff matchups that you'll see tomorrow, noon Eastern time, on ESPN and the ESPN app. Semifinals in the Rose Bowl game presented by Capital One, 5 Eastern on New Year's Day, followed by the Allstate Sugar Bowl. Reese and the guys tomorrow also have the unveiling of the New Year's 6 bowl games, final top 25 rankings. Here's Kevin Nagandi after the touchback. All right, Kevin Booger here. It is 14-0 Oklahoma. Iowa State did drive on its last possession and missed a field goal. Brock Purdy, the quarterback, under pressure, steps up. Got pulled down by Nick Benito. Gain of a yard. There is a flag down. Jordan Kelly put pressure on. Backup nose out of Tulsa, Oklahoma.
I think they're going to get Darryl Simmons with the hold, number 55.
Personal foul, chop block, offense, number 76 and 55. Half the distance to the goal, still first down.
Joey Ramos in there at right tackle. Watch the right side here. They both get involved. It's an inside stunt. Oklahoma runs a ton of stunts. Just about every play, they're doing some kind of game or twist inside. That time it fooled the Iowa State offensive line on the right side.
Makes it first and 22. Purdy on the design rollout. Had Hutchinson curling open, but missed him high.
When these teams played in Ames, Iowa State fell behind 17-6. They were behind in the second quarter and battled back and trailed a couple different times in that ball game. They also had two games they were behind it by double digits in the second half. But Oklahoma looks very sharp right now offensively. I don't think they can afford to let this game get much further away.
It's definitely a better Oklahoma team than the one that lost in Ames in early October. Some moving along the offensive line. The return of Perkins and Stevenson, obviously the biggest reason why Oklahoma is better.
False start. Offense. Number 57, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
That's the first team offensive lineman, Colin Newell. First team all conference. Well, since the loss at Iowa State, and that was on the heels of a loss to Kansas State, they've gone 6-0 since, have the Sooners, and outscored the opponents in those six by 155 per game. Breece Hall on second and 27 gets a yard. Robert Barnes, linebacker, converted safety, made the tackle.
They've got some more length in their defensive secondary, and they've moved some guys in. They're playing a lot of guys, rotating a lot of guys in the back end of their defense. DJ Graham, a freshman corner, in right now, number 9.
And Ronnie Perkins is back too, Todd, number 7. And he's made a huge difference and brings a ton of energy to this defense.
He'll be after Purdy here on third down and 26. Jirel Brock comes in as the running back. They go to a quick wide receiver screen, just trying to get some yards. And Hutchinson got taken down by Nick Benito, well short of the line to make.
You know, Sean, I know that was a third and 26. Very difficult situation for the offense. But the difference in watching this Oklahoma defense now from when we saw them early, they are flying around and playing with a different edge, a different confidence. That it just looks like a completely different defensive football team. And that guy, Ronnie Perkins, I think, is a big reason for that.
Well, Alex Grinch, the coordinator, uses the word disruptive. That defensive line has become disruptive. Short punt by Rivera. And it takes a bad bounce for the Cyclones as well. Down by Kyle at the 50-yard line. So great field position for Spencer Rattler, and the Sooners already leading 14-0 with 13 to go till halftime. Oh, Norman, Oklahoma is title town of the Big 12. They've won 5 Big 12 titles in a row, 13 in all in 24 years of the Big 12, established in 1996. Lincoln Riley's 3-for-3 as the head coach, winning the conference. The Cyclones haven't won a conference championship since 1912, when they were in the Missouri Valley, and they went 2-0 and shared the conference title. Rattler takes off and gets to the 46. And as you might expect with the history such as they are, Oklahoma has absolutely dominated the head-to-head rivalry throughout the years. The win was just the 7th for Iowa State head-to-head. Here are the historical differences. They've never had a 10-win season. At Iowa State, 9 is the record. They could match that today and do it for the third time. Number of championships, dramatically different. Really none of that matters today. The fake to Stevenson. Rattler forced to retreat and throws it away. General direction of Charleston Rambo.
See the arm strength of Rattler. That's not an easy throw away because he was not out of the tackle box. Right? He had a receiver in the area, but it was all the way on the other side of the field. He had to launch that football just to make it a legal play.
And it was a smart play by him. And really, I think it's only the second incompletion so far today.
Yeah, 10 of 12. And it was a smart play. You're right. Live to play this down.
This is a big down. You'd have to think, especially for Iowa State. Oklahoma trying to take firm early control of this one. Mims did not get to the 40-yard line, down 3 yards short, and now Lincoln Riley has a decision to make on 4th and 3.
I think you punt the football. Your defense has played so well down the stretch here. Pin Iowa State back like you had them the last possession and just keep playing field position. You're playing a beautiful football game right now, offense and defense. Complement it with a good special teams play here.
Reese Munshaw, the punter, back in his home state from New Braunfels, Texas. Tariq Milton back to receive it for the Cyclones.
False start. Offense, number 51, 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
You see Shane Beamer there, very involved in the special teams, just like his dad. This is his last game on the staff here at Oklahoma, going on to become the head coach at South Carolina. Great opportunity for him.
Well, really nice people in coaching, not a surprise. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. And Frank Beamer, certainly all class. Munchaw's punt. And what a bounce.
There's a flag down back by the punter.
You wonder if they hit the punter.
Well, he might want to get hit every time because that was a beautiful punt.
It was one of the best punts I've ever seen.
Alvarez indicating to Lincoln Riley it's only a 5-yard penalty, so I would think they would turn it down. It won't give him a first down. They'll take the ball down there at the 2.
By the end of the kicker, defense number 85. That penalty is declined. First down, Iowa State. Timeout.
Aiden Bitter called for the penalty that's turned down. Oh, wow. Oh. Great job by Munshaw. Found at the 2. This season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. Each team has missed a field goal today. Iowa State down 14-0. Reese Hall trying to find some running room, and he got nothing.
You know, when these teams played in Ames, Breece Hall was held pretty in check for the first 3 quarters. They fed him the football in the fourth quarter. He ended up with 139 yards. But again, this defense has improved for Oklahoma. They have the best run defense in the conference, holding opponents to 88 yards a game.
It's the most competent defense I've seen from Oklahoma in years.
They're fourth in the nation in rushing defense. Hall entered leading the nation in total yards for a running back, averaging over 137 yards per game. They stick with him. He's out to the 5. No other running back has rushed for more than 73 yards against Oklahoma this year. And as you said, Todd, Hall had 139. Number 1 in the country in total rush yards, for the Oklahoma defense, 4th in the country in run defense.
And in that game in Ames, they leaned on him in the fourth quarter. They gave it to him 10 times in the fourth quarter, and that's when he had his biggest runs, including a 36-yarder. But They were right in that ball game. It was a one-score game.
They really need a conversion here on third down and eight. Purdy avoided a sack and a safety. Got it away, and it's an incomplete pass. Tried to dump it off to Breece Hall with Brendan Radley-Hiles in the area. It was Perrion Winfrey. Looked like he had a great chance to take down Purdy in the end zone for two more points.
Watch Winfrey. He's going to run right through two blockers. Alex Grinch says this junior college transfer next year has a chance to be one of the best defensive linemen in the country. He has really started to come on here late in the season, and that is an unbelievable play. Ran through two Iowa State linemen.
So here's Joe Rivera to punt again. Fifth-year senior. No rush. Another low kick. Marvin Mims. Whoop. He got blasted along the far side of the field.
See, Mims knew that there was a defender outside, and he was looking at the outside defender, and he lost track of number 41. He's trying to brace himself for the hit from the outside.
By Kobe Hathcock.
Wow.
Give him credit. He popped right up, though.
Hathcock, the primary hit.
Great field position nonetheless for Oklahoma again.
Tavon Kyle also part of that sandwich. Sooners from the 40, that excellent field position. Ramondre Stevenson broke a couple of tackles at the line, lunged ahead for two.
Mike Rose in on that tackle. Defensive player of the year in the conference. Not only the leading tackler on this team, but the leading interceptor in the conference. I mean, he's been a really valuable player.
Has four interceptions, tied for the national lead among linebackers. Another player wasn't highly recruited at the Power 5 level. He had committed to Ball State. Stevenson spins ahead. Here's Allison Williams.
Guys, watching Mike Rose on the sideline, he is so upbeat and so positive with his guys as he paces. He usually has a towel on his head, and he just kept telling them, keep being us, do what we do, and keep having fun. I mean, he has stayed so positive, but defensive coordinator John Haycock, he was fired up, yelling at the top of his lungs to his guys, nobody wants us to win this thing. Go out there and take it.
Rose, a great team leader. He was showing blitz and backed off. Rattler pulls it down, throws on the run. It's incomplete. Intended for Jeremiah Hall. Broken up by Arnold Azuna, who's the player thrust into action after the starter, Aishim Young, was ejected just more than a half minute into the game for targeting.
Really nice play by Azuna. Timed it perfectly. Got a hand in there. He got the hit in the back. It's a good throw by Rattler, but a nice play by Azuna to knock it out.
Another guy playing close to home. He's from just down the street in Grand Prairie, Texas. So now Gabe Berkich is going to try a long one. This would be a 54-yarder, which would be a career long. His career long is 51 in the game earlier this year at Iowa State. He's made three from 50-plus this year. And that one is good. Gabe Berkich, a 54-yarder, longest of his career to extend the Oklahoma lead to 17-0. We missed earlier from 36.
The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Football Championship game on ABC is brought to you by Ice Cold Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville. In part by Pacific Life, more than 150 years strong, trust in your tomorrow. And Burger King, mix and match your favorites for just $5.
The Oklahoma Sooners have won the last five Big 12 championships. Meanwhile, Iowa State trying to win its first conference title. Third in school history, first one since the 1912 Missouri Valley Championship, when they won it with a league record of 2-0. Big wins over Missouri and Drake. And a kickoff out of bounds from Gabe Barkich. So each team's done that
kick
once
out
today.
Of bounds. Kicking team. First down at the 35-yard line.
You know, it's interesting, Sean, as this Oklahoma football team, their last game, they did not play very well against Baylor. They were missing a lot of guys. Lincoln Riley said he really scaled back the offensive game plan. A much different looking team today. But this has kind of been their trend. In the last 5 years, they have put together at least a five-game winning streak heading into their bowl game. And this is, they're kind of right on cue with that, playing their best football right now at the end of the year. They've won six in a row coming into this game. A much different team than we saw in Ames.
A six-game winning streak after back-to-back regular season losses for the first time since 1999, which was Bob Stoops' first year. Purdy after the run fake to Breece Hall. Has Dylan Sainer, one of those big tight ends. He bounced off a couple of tacklers, and you can understand why he would. He's enormous at 6'7", 272.
Well, nice job by Hutchison. Or Joe Skates, rather, getting a little bit of a screen there. The defender inside was not able to get out to Sainer, and they got the completion.
You had to feel bad there for Trey Norwood. That was almost unfair. Here's Breece Hall, chopped down, or that might have been a much longer run. Delarian Turner Yell took him down, and he limps. Well, stays in.
You almost get the feel, Sean, this has to be a touchdown drive for Iowa State now. They're in good field position. I think Matt Campbell's got to be thinking four down territory, stay ahead of the chains here because they have got to cut into this 17-0 lead.
And Coach Campbell in his fifth year, 3-9 the first year, but they've had four straight winning seasons since then. And that's the first time in school history they've had four winning seasons in a row. Nothing there for Breece Hall. Here comes third down and two midway through the second quarter. LaRonda McDaniel, Breece Hall's mother, is here from Wichita, Kansas. His stepfather, Jeff Smith, was a running back at Nebraska. He played in the NFL for Kansas City and Tampa Bay. They've held him in check today, 10 carries, 33 yards. As you said, Todd, probably four down territory here. And a timeout called by Oklahoma. With 6:57 to go in the first half of the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship from Arlington, Texas. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear, celebrating the endless pursuit of forward momentum. Goodyear, more driven. And don't forget, we have the Dr. Pepper tuition giveaway coming up at halftime of today's game.
This is where Charlie Kohler's got to come up for a big play here on third down.
Third and two. They're down 17-0. Probably four down territory. And Breece Hall gets nothing. Driven back, in fact. Well, they're going to give him forward progress to the line of scrimmage.
I think they're definitely got to go for it. You know, the discouraging part is, the last two times Breece Hall has run the football, he has not gained much more than an inch. So do you trust trying to run again? I think you got to throw. I think it's got to be Brock Purdy making a play.
Jake Remsburg, starting right tackle, out of his uniform. Left arm injury. Joey Ramos, who was a starter earlier in the year, is in at right tackle. Oklahoma crowding the line of scrimmage. Purdy trying to draw them offside.
They got it.
He did. I mean, there would look like there was contact there. Matt Campbell going crazy. Nobody threw a flag.
There had to be contact.
Iowa State called their first timeout of the half. 30 seconds in length.
The way Brock Purdy was operating, it looked like they weren't ever going to run a play. They were only trying to get the offsides. They got it on this one, I think. I mean, that's... no contact, I guess he'd get back. But Brock Purdy definitely trying to use the hard count and the head bob to draw the penalty. And Matt Campbell's got to get himself under control
here.
He
is losing his mind down here on the field.
Because now he has to make a decision what to do on fourth down.
Well, he's still upset from what happened a half minute into the game when Akeem Young was ejected for targeting. We heard what he said to David Alvarez, the referee. That's football. And was very spicy in explaining why he hated the call. Allison Williams told us John Haycock, the defense coordinator, said, nobody wants us to win this game. I think they feel like they're not getting a fair shake from the officiating crew.
But cooler heads have to prevail right now.
And they are going for it on fourth down and two. Hall, the running back.
Good keep by Purdy.
Great call by Tom Manning. Purdy executes and gets shoved out of bounds by Woody Washington. I'd like to bring in Matt Austin here for two quick things, Matt, very quickly. Should there have been a penalty for offside? And should Matt Campbell be flagged for this behavior?
I don't think there should have been a flag for offside. I didn't see any contact. The nose guard came across. The guard didn't flinch, didn't appear to move at all. So I think that's a good no call. The center should have snapped the ball when he came across. Right. They'd have got a free 5 yards. And Coach Campbell, unfortunately, if you're acting like that on the field, that's pretty much an automatic flag if you're arguing a call. So, yes, he should have got a 15-yard unsportsmanlike penalty.
And Matt, also on that, when the lineman comes across the field, if the guard moves, like in reaction, that draws the penalty as well, right?
That is correct.
Timeout, Iowa State. So more importantly, after the high emotion from the head coach and his team, they execute a play they absolutely had to have.
Yeah.
And again, the players trying to calm down Coach Campbell. He is a fiery competitor who has done one of the great coaching jobs in recent college football history, long one of the doormats of major college football. They are a team eyeing the college football playoff possibility if they could win today.
Well, he does need to calm down. He needs to calm down right now because his team needs him to be calm. They want his emotion. They want his fire. But he's got to have a cool head in the decision-making part of
it. And let's be fair to the officials. Right? Matt Austin told us on the targeting 30 yep. seconds into the game, by the way the rules are written, that was the right call.
Right.
And the officiating crew did a good job there because it didn't look like there was contact.
Right.
And there wasn't movement along the offensive line. And the Oklahoma players got back.
And they were pretty gracious in not flagging him
absolutely.
For his behavior.
Brock Purdy throws into a crowd and it's intercepted. A terrible mistake by Purdy, and Trey Norwood has another interception.
We talked about the defensive front. The other big difference in this Oklahoma defense is their defensive backs now are making plays on the football, especially this guy, Trey Norwood, his fourth interception. They know that Purdy loves to go to Kohler in the red zone, and Trey Norwood went up and got the football.
Time for today's Dr. Pepper Spotlight. It's Trey Norwood. Missed all of last season with a knee injury. And Todd, if you're Brock Purdy, you can't miss that throw short, right? That
has you got to throw it to the back pylon. Let your guy have a chance or no one.
They're leading 17-0. They go to a reverse. T.J. Pledger gave it to Marvin Mims, and that's dropped at the line of scrimmage. Nicely played by Daytron Young. Purdy's interception, the first turnover of the game for either team.
And for Oklahoma, their fifth consecutive game with a takeaway. And really, again, that is one of the biggest differences in this football team from when we saw them earlier. Alex Grinch has always prided himself on defenses that take the football away. They weren't doing it last year. They weren't doing it early this year. They are now.
Rattler looking deep after the play fake, trying to run away from Rose. He throws it away. And this brings to mind a play we saw earlier in the game that Matt Austin talked about during a commercial break, the notion of intentional grounding.
Sean, earlier, that ball was thrown 20, 25 yards out of bounds.
All right, Todd, so let's bring in Matt Austin on this play.
Well, the difference on this one, he's outside the tackle box, right, Matt?
Todd's exactly correct. If you get outside the tackle box and get it past the line of scrimmage, you're fine. But if you're in the box, you've got to throw it near a receiver, and 10 to 15 yards out of bounds is not near a receiver.
Tentative rush on third down and 10. Rattler's throw is low, so Weiss no opportunity to run after the catch and get the first down. They settle for 8.
I put that on Weiss, too. He has to know what he needs for the first down. I mean, that's just a simple curl route. Take it beyond the marker and not even worry about yards after the catch.
Reese Munchaw on the punt again. Tariq Milton back deep. We're ticking down to 4 minutes to go in the opening half. Munchaw, good kick. High. Nose up spiral, and Milton makes the fair catch at the Iowa State 33. Time now for the Aflac trivia question. Oklahoma and Clemson have each won 5 straight outright conference titles. Oklahoma could make it 6 in a row in the Big 12 today. Clemson could make it 6 straight ACC titles. Later today on ABC against Notre Dame, we want to know which FBS team was the last to win 6 conference titles in a row. You don't look like you know this
one. I don't know this one.
This is Prize. Been outstanding all season long. Brock Purdy, the play fake to Breece Hall. Had to get rid of it. And he throws incomplete for Charlie Kohler. I know Oklahoma has won 6 in a row. That was back in the 70s. I don't know if that was the most recent. Here's the answer. BYU.
Wow. No, I wouldn't have guessed that.
No. 7 straight in the whack. Glory days of Lavelle Edwards. These are active winning streaks, conference championships, 5 each for Clemson and for Oklahoma. Oklahoma leading this one 17-0. Cyclones still trying to get Breece Hall loose. DJ Graham took him down there. It'll be another 3rd down and about 6. Breece Hall has run for at least 90 yards in every game this year. He has 8 100-yard games, most in the country, but they have bottled him up today. They haven't converted on a 3rd down. 0 for 5 are the Cyclones. 3rd and 6 from their own 38. Purdy gets grabbed and face masked. A big break for Iowa State. And they could use one. Not much has gone their way, but Perrion Winfrey poised to sack him, grabbed the face mask to do it.
Well, we saw him run through 2 defenders. This time he just ripped the center, Colin Newell. Mask.
Defense, you're right, 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
I mean, he just whips right through the center, Colin Newell. That's a hard ask for a center to block a guy that quick and powerful without any help from a guard. And Iowa State benefited from the penalty.
Winfrey and Newell woofing at each other. Newell, the centers from right there in Ames, Iowa, grew up a huge Cyclone fan, sold programs at Jack Trice Stadium as a kid. Dreamed about playing for the Cyclones. You wonder if the dream was big enough to include appearing in a conference championship game. Purdy, another play action fake, and has a man breaking free. It's caught. It's Landon Akers out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Now this is perfect pass protection. They give Brock Purdy a clean pocket. Watch how long he's able to stay in here with this protection. Excellent job off the play action. This is a deep over route. It takes time to develop. Nice clean pocket. He's able to lead Akers away from the defender and a big chunk play off of play action.
For 25 yards. You know, Todd, we've watched this whole half, and not much has gone Iowa State's way. They score in this game.
Yeah, they're still right in it.
Yeah, it doesn't.
But they have to score.
It really, I think if you're an Oklahoma fan, you feel like, you know, we're comfortably ahead, but we should be more comfortable. Here's Breece Hall. Has some room outside this time. Has the first down, and gets bounced out of bounds by Trey Norwood. It'll be 1st and goal for Iowa State.
Watch Jared Russ, number 43, kind of get a lead block. He's going to be coming in motion, and he's going to get out here in front of him and get a nice block on Ronnie Perkins, and that enables Breece Hall to get to the corner. Sean, you said they've had him bottled up, but he's such a great player. You just keep feeding him the football because eventually he's going to make some plays for you.
He gets stronger as the game goes on.
Yep. 10 carries in the fourth quarter when they played earlier in the year, and he took over the game.
And 15-yard gain, his longest rush. First and goal there at the 7. Designed run for Brock Purdy. And he is run out of bounds by Pat Fields. Iowa fans thought there was a shove out of bounds. Iowa State fans not going to get the flag.
It was a little bit of a push. I don't think enough to draw a penalty. Although you always wonder if a guy is guilty when he puts his arms up like that immediately after making a play.
Matt Austin, your opinion. Should have been a penalty or no?
No, I don't think so. It was just a little shove, but you're right. By putting the arms up, that's the I'm guilty signal.
Aishim Young, starting defensive back, ejected for targeting, less than a minute in. On second and goal, Purdy throws for Kohler. Touchdown, Iowa State.
Nice little combination route between Sean Shaw and Kohler. Kohler gets inside. Watch the route. He's working on Trey Brown. He's a 5'9 corner. The corner gets picked off a little bit by Sean Shaw. And Kohler able to get the football into the end zone. And a much needed Cyclone touchdown.
16th of his career, most ever by an Iowa State tight end. Connor Asali adds the extra point. Has seen for much of this half that Iowa State has been hanging on for dear life. They know they can come back from double digits. They've done it 3 times this year, including against Oklahoma. And a nice bounce back after the bad mistake made by Brock Purdy on the previous drive. Charlie Kohler from Norman, Oklahoma, grew up a huge Sooner fan. Both of his parents, when he was a kid, were professors. His dad, Randy, leads the civil engineering program still at OU. His mom was a law school professor. She's now at Oklahoma City University. When they beat Oklahoma, Charlie said it was extra special for him to help the Cyclones beat the Sooners. It's also a fine basketball program. Norman North, best player obviously on that team was Trey Young. We tried to get him to say that Charlie would have had more points if Trey Young would pass the ball every now and then. Drake Stoops, the Oklahoma wide receiver, also on that basketball team. He wasn't bitter the Sooners didn't recruit him. He said, you know, I had one Power 5 offer.
Right.
It was from Iowa State. He weighed 220 pounds.
Wasn't he a pleasant guy to talk to on the phone?
he's one of the most interesting people we've talked to. We should not leave out, he's a 3.99 GPA in mechanical engineering, football and academic All-American, first double duo in school history. Here comes Trey Brown with a big return for Oklahoma. Trying to stop whatever momentum Iowa State might be hoping to build. He's down at the 45-yard line of the Cyclones.
Well, remember in the game in Ames, it was a short kickoff, but it was an Iowa State kickoff return that kind of sparked them. Trey Brown now getting out past the 50 on a short kick, and Oklahoma can be very aggressive right now with this offensive possession.
Well, the kickoff team has been a big problem all year long for Iowa State. They've tried 4 different kickoff men. Special teams really hurt them in their season opening loss to Louisiana.
Well, remember the first kickoff of the game, they kicked it out of bounds. So they've struggled here tonight in that department as well.
Minute 26 to go in the half. 2 timeouts for OU. Rattler out firing. Another low throw and the catch made by Theo Wiest. Short of the first down and inbound, so the clock will run.
Such a huge break on the kickoff return, because again, now Lincoln Riley can be very aggressive. He's got 2 timeouts. Great field position.
Rattler the play fake.
Same little
and
slip.
Stevenson open up the middle. To the 23-yard line he goes. This all set up by the 43-yard kickoff return by Trey Brown.
God, I love this play. I mean, they're able to, they got Jeremiah Hall going out in the flat, and they got Stevenson slipping inside, and Spencer Rattler gets to choose which one he wants.
have plenty of time here. They really don't need to hurry. Ramondre Stevenson breaking tackles and down at the 9-yard line. Lawrence White made the stop with help from Arnold Azuna.
Remember, Iowa State won the toss and deferred. They're going to get the ball to start the third quarter. Trying to get one more stop before halftime, and the kickoff return has put Oklahoma right on the doorstep of another touchdown.
Officials timeout for an injury to a defensive player.
Well, great Arnold Azuna, who was the man who became more prominent after Nysheim Young left the game for targeting. Kickoff return by Brown, the longest of the season for Oklahoma. He had not returned to kickoff all year.
Well, now you wonder, who does John Haycock go with now? You've lost Nysheim Young. Azuna's got to come out for at least a play.
They've put Mason Chambers, a true freshman, Schertz, Texas, number 33 in there. There's one of the rule changes this year. When you're ejected for targeting, you don't have to go to the locker room. You can stay on the sidelines with your team. It has to be agonizing for Nysheim Young. Capital One halftime report coming up. Kevin Negandhi, Booger McFarland, Mark Sanchez. I'll tell you about the other conference championship action already underway.
You know, we haven't mentioned it yet, but Oklahoma playing out without one of their best offensive weapons, Austin Stogner, their tight end, and especially in this part of the field, he is a guy that Spencer Rattler was very comfortable with, a big target, not available in the ball game tonight.
Missing his third straight game with a lower body injury. Rattler, design keep, turns the corner and scores. Jake Hummel couldn't take him down at the corner, and Rattler was on his way to the end zone with a 9-yard score. A gigantic response by Oklahoma after Iowa State got within 10. Fifth rushing touchdown of the year for the redshirt freshman Spencer Rattler. Gabe Berkich adds the extra point.
He's listed at 5'9", 190. He's a redshirt sophomore. He's got a familiar name. Drake Stoops, watch the block. He gets right here on the linebacker Hummel that's going to spring his quarterback to the end zone. He's a feisty, tough little blocker, and he gets the key block there, and Spencer Rattler gets the touchdown.
Fourth different starting quarterback in as many years for Oklahoma. All the previous three did. Two of them, Baker Mayfield, Kyler Murray, won the Heisman and were the number one overall pick in the draft. Jalen Hurts transfers in from Alabama. He finishes second in the Heisman voting. But Rattler has stepped in. He reminds a lot of people, including Lincoln Riley, of Baker Mayfield. Yeah.
Well, I think because of his ability to extend plays and make throws on the move outside of the pocket, and throws that can be deep down the field. The two quarterbacks that played most recently, Jalen Hurts and Kyler Murray, both more run guys, and they did a lot more with the quarterback run with those two guys. Spencer plays a lot, plays the game a lot like Baker Mayfield.
There's a touchback off the foot of Berkich. So Purdy with only one timeout, 37 seconds to go. How do you play it here?
You see if you can get a first down. You got to be smart here. You can't do anything careless with the football. You're going to get the football to start the third quarter. So you call a couple plays here. If you can get a first down, then maybe you use the timeout. You try to get yourself in position, but I would expect it to be pretty safe. Try to gear up for the third quarter and see if you can get yourself back in the football game.
They shift Breece Hall back to the right hip of Purdy. Swung out here wide to Tariq Milton with some blockers. They get eight, but he stays in bounds. And so far, no inclination to use the timeout from Coach Campbell. Marked it back at the 32, so a 7-yard pickup. It looks like the Cyclones are going to let the half end.
Again, I think if you were kicking off to start the third quarter, you might have approached that 37 seconds a little differently, but with you getting the football, you've got to go in and get some things fixed in the locker room, and you couldn't afford a big mistake here right before the half.
Largest deficit ever overcome in a Big 12 title game is 17 points. Oklahoma did it from 17-0 down to beat Nebraska in 2010. Rattler threw for 184 and a touchdown. He ran for a score. And Ramondre Stevenson rushed for 67 yards on 10 carries in the half. Here's Allison Williams.
Coach Campbell, what was your reaction to giving up that last touchdown to Oklahoma?
Yeah, you know, our defense has actually done a really good job most of the day. We put them in some tough situations. So we'll get it figured out. We're going to go into the locker room and come out and play our best 30 minutes.
I saw you talk to your quarterback, Brock Purdy, right before he headed into the locker room. What do you want him to know?
Well, it's fun because this is where we live. Really hard, really tough environments, and we're going to see what we're made of.
How much of an impact did that early targeting call have on your defense?
Yeah, you know, I actually, the two guys that have gone in have done a really good job. Young guys that just keep playing football, and you just got to live with it and keep playing.
Thanks, Matt.
Thank you.
Well, he's calmed down significantly. But, you know, inside that heart is still pumping with great vigor. 24-7 Oklahoma at the half. We'll send you to the Capital One halftime report after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Welcome back to Dr. Pepper Championship Week.
And this is the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship game on ABC. Big part of Dr. Pepper Championship Week from Arlington, Texas at the half. Oklahoma trying to win its sixth Big 12 title in a row, leading Iowa State 24-7. Here's our Pacific Life game summary.
Well, Oklahoma was very sharp, particularly quarterback Spencer Rattler starting the game 14 of 18, seeing the field, playing well within the scheme. Also had a 9-yard touchdown run. Brock Purdy, a rare interception thrown in the red zone, only the second in his entire career, and Oklahoma continues their takeaway trend here in the last four or five ball games.
Rattler will wait. Brock Purdy and the Iowa State Cyclones will get the ball first here in the second half. Well, the kickoff return was a big play for Iowa State in their win of the regular season against Oklahoma by that man, Kene Nwangu, running back 85 yards after they went behind by 7 late in the game. And we had a big kickoff return for Oklahoma in the first half today. No fair catch this time. And they'll begin near the 25-yard line. We welcome you back, Sean McDonough, along with Todd Blackledge, and obviously a very important opening possession of this second half for Iowa State.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, they've got to get something going and get points on the board, because right now at 17, they can still keep Breece Hall involved in the game. I mean, he still is such a valuable part, but if they get further behind, it's tougher to try to run the football and use up so much clock. So they've got to be productive here on this drive and keep number 28 as a major factor with their offense.
Offensive player of the year in the Big 12, selected by the coaches. Breece Hall rushed for 52 on 4 yards per carry. He averages over 6 yards per carry coming in. They start the half with him for almost nothing. Deshaun White made the tackle. They've come from behind from double digits twice in the second half, when they were down by double figures 17-6 against Oklahoma in the first half of October in Ames. You know, Matt Campbell's one of those coaches who preaches it and means it, one play at a time, one day at a time. Never look ahead. And that mindset's been a big part of their success. Purdy throws, and it is incomplete. Intended for Land and Acres and broken up by Woody Washington.
I think Woody Washington was kind of lucky on that play because he didn't know where the football was. Acres did. Woody Washington didn't get his head around to see the football, but he was still able to get a hand in there. I mean, that's a heck of an athletic play by Washington when he didn't really know where the ball was.
Third down and 9. They bring in their third down back, Jirell Brock. Three receiver bunch to the right. Purdy in trouble and cannot escape. He's down back at the 21. Nick Bonito took him down.
Well, this is really a good job by Alex Grinch, because first of all, he's going to take Perkins and he's going to spy him. Here's Bonito. He's going to get the sack, but because Purdy saw Perkins sitting there, he kind of slowed up and Bonito was able to get him from behind. It was a three-man rush with Ronnie Perkins serving as a spy. And Bonito comes through with the sack.
That's the difference this year with this defense. They have a pass rush. They really do. He had 6.5 sacks coming into the game, Bonito.
You know, all in the last five games. Now he's 7.5 in the last six games. Good punt by Rivera. Mims frustrated that he couldn't field it. And it's down at the 25-yard line. Spencer Rattler had a very good first half.
Yeah, he really did. I mean, you see his skill set. Again, his ability to extend a play and make an accurate throw down the field on the move. Watch this one. This is as good of a throw as you're going to see all college football season. Layers it over a linebacker in front of a safety for another big completion. And then the touchdown throw to Mims. Little play action. He catches the open field. He sees his man one-on-one, and he gets him the football.
He shovels it ahead on the first play from scrimmage of the second half. Ramondre Stevenson dragged down by Lawrence White after a gain of 5. Well, Rattler in the first game against Iowa State, I think what people remember most is the interception at the end of the game when they were down by 7 that ended the game. But Lincoln Riley said he thought that game was a turning point from a positive standpoint. He made a lot of plays throughout that game, threw for 300 yards, rushed for a touchdown, and has played up very well since. He runs, doesn't quite get to the marker.
And again, at that point in the season, Oklahoma was not running the football very well, not nearly as well as they are at this point in the season with Ramondre Stevenson and their offensive line growing up.
Well, they brought back only 20% of their rushing yards from last year. Jalen Hurts, the quarterback, was their leading rusher, over 1,000. Kennedy Brooks, number two, he opted out. They didn't have Stevenson.
Trey Sermon transferred to Ohio State.
They're trying to invent it on the fly. And third and a foot, they go to the passing game. Might have outsmarted themselves there. It's an incomplete pass for Theo Weiss. Well, you have a big lead. You have Stevenson in the backfield.
Yeah, 246 pounds, Sean. You got a 246-pound back. I'm surprised.
I think they did Iowa State a favor. Yeah. You know, Iowa State on its heels and had a deflating first possession of this half. This might give them a lift. Here's Reeves Munshaw again. High kick, short. Tariq Milton comes out to the 32-yard line to make the fair catch.
It's Monday night!
I don't know how we follow that, except to say it is the Steelers and the Bengals capping week 15. ESPN ABC, Deportes in the app, 8 o'clock following Monday Night Countdown, which starts the coverage at 6 Eastern Time. Each team has had it once here in the second half. Each has punted. Still 24-7 Oklahoma. Breece Hall reverses his field and has a lot of work to do to get back to the line. Woody Washington made the play. Here's Allison Williams.
Sean, I asked Lincoln Riley what he's seen from his defense in the first half that's allowed them to hold Iowa State to 7 points. And he said what we've seen to start the second half. They've done a good job of getting pressure on Brock Purdy and containing Breece Hall. He said we've also done a really good job of limiting those big plays. On the offensive side of the ball, really pleased with quarterback Spencer Rattler playing within himself, his decision making, and his ability to make plays when he scrambles.
On second and 10, Brock Purdy in trouble again, and down he goes. Back near the 30-yard line, Josh Ellison and Ronnie Perkins had a meeting at the quarterback.
Well, they're doing this again. Now, this time, they took Ellison as the spy and let Perkins rush. He beats Joey Ramos, the right tackle, and there's
Ellison there to help out in case he got loose. Nice job of rushing three, dropping one of them with eyes on the quarterback.
Perkins is fun to watch. He plays so hard, it doesn't matter, run or pass, every single down.
All three of those three defensive linemen, Perkins, Winfrey, and Thomas, were second team all-conference. They felt it was disrespectful. They had a point to make today, and they're making it. Brock Purdy, big play. First down all the way to midfield. Comes up at the 49-yard line.
Well, just when they need it again, Winfrey with great pressure. He whips the center again, and Purdy makes a play when they absolutely had to have it. Good feel for the running lanes.
They come to the line quickly after the 18-yard play. Purdy throws it right away. Intercepted by Pat Fields. Another terrible decision by Brock Purdy. His second interception. Both and his team had some momentum. And Pat Fields has his first career interception in his junior year.
He's going to try to get the ball to Chase Allen. But watch, Trey Norwood, number 13, is going to have a hold of Allen's right arm. So Allen can only get one arm up. The ball goes over his head, and Fields comes up with the interception, but not a good decision of where to throw the football. On the outside, Hutchinson might have been open, but all eyes on the quarterback, and they read Purdy on the scramble.
Pat Fields playing in his 29th career game. He has started 23 as his first career interception. Junior from Tulsa out of Union High School. Deep drop by Rattler. They want a momentum continuer into double coverage and incomplete. That was reminiscent of the interception he threw at the end of the regular season game when he lofted one into double coverage, was trying to get it there to Marvin Mims. Young and Eisworth had the coverage.
Yeah, perfect position by both defenders, not able to come down with the football. Lincoln Riley choosing to try to go for the jugular there after the turnover.
Ramondre Stevenson driven back near the line of scrimmage. Mike Rose and Will McDonald. And this was the interception down by a touchdown late, trying to make the big play. Lincoln Riley said he learned from that. Spencer Rattler told us the other day he learned from that as well.
When he said that the biggest improvement for him has been taking care of the football better, and he's done that tonight.
That pass batted down by Jaquan Bailey, one of the great defensive ends in Iowa State history, all-time sack man at Iowa State with 25 and a half career sacks, and that'll force another punt.
Well, the Cyclone defense doing their part coming out of the locker room. That time Bailey knew he couldn't get to the quarterback, working on Eric Swenson, the left tackle. Just timed his jump and got hands on the football.
Still, you feel like Oklahoma has some chances to deliver more of a knockout punch and can't quite do it.
Well, hasn't it felt like the whole game they've had the field position, too?
Munshaw, fair catch made by Tariq Milton. Then again, it's also felt like Iowa State's had chances to make plays, and they haven't really done it as well.
The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Football Championship game on ABC is brought to you by Ice Cold Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville, and in part by ThriveEnd, thrive with purpose.
As you mentioned, both these starting quarterbacks, Brock Purdy and Spencer Rattler from the Phoenix, Arizona area, they knew each other in large part, even though they didn't play against each other, because they were at a lot of the same awards banquets. Rattler threw for a state record, 11,083 yards. Brock Purdy was the player of the year in 2017. He set the single season 6A mark with 4,400 yards passing. Rattler, the consensus number one quarterback in the class of 2019 out of Pinnacle High School. Breece Hall carries, and the talent is obvious for Spencer Rattler.
Yeah.
Purdy was a high recruit. He visited Alabama, Matter of fact, Matt Campbell told us I was kind of relieved that he kept his commitment to us after I found out that he visited Alabama.
Well, didn't he? Wasn't he sick at some point in high school and missed some time, and then people got kind of a late start on him recruiting, and but he wound up in a great spot.
Yeah, that big year that we just showed you got everybody's attention. Made some key mistakes today. Tried to get that one to Sean Shaw.
Well, this is just pressure. I mean, this is hard to make a throw with a guy like Josh Ellison bearing down on you. I mean, it's a quick throw, so you expect protection to make that throw, but Ellison was in the backfield and caused the errant throw by Brock Purdy.
What you've said, and Todd McShay has said, the presence of Perkins has made that defensive line so much better. He's facing Purdy a lot more heat than he saw in the regular season.
No question. They sacked him once in that other game, but relentless pressure tonight, and neither team doing anything on third down.
Really nothing on offense here in this third quarter. Purdy.
Whoa.
What a competitor. Took a hit up high. And they're going to mark him down short of the first down. Brian Asamoah credited with the stop.
I'll tell you what, he's kind of loose with that football, too. There's the end of it. Asamoah kind of gets him around the head and neck area. Nothing to deserve a flag, but Brock Purdy fighting for that first down comes up a little short.
Would you go for this, or at least be tempted to? Fourth and one, down by three scores with eight to go in the third quarter.
I would still punt it. I would still punt it.
You're very conservative.
I am.
Bill Belichick would definitely go for it.
This part of the field, I'm not going for it.
Well, if you're going to win, you have to start scoring eventually.
Yes, you do.
Several times, in fact. Joe Rivera's punt taken in by Marvin Mims, a fair catch at the 30. And Oklahoma fine with these exchanges of punts. Here's the college football rankings. Brought to you by AT&T 5G. These are the college football playoff rankings. Controversial to some. Iowa State moved up to six.
Yeah.
And at least into a spot where, with a win today, they might have a shot.
Well, 6-4 is doable, right? Oklahoma was six last year and made it into the playoffs, but no team with two losses has ever made it in. So that's working against them. Of course, they've got a lot working against them right now in this ball game.
Ramondre Stevenson bounces off the pile. He gets about six. You'd have to think Alabama is going to be one of the four in the college football playoff, which starts on New Year's Day, no matter what happens today.
I think so.
Clemson and Notre Dame playing again. From the 36, Rattler takes off running again. And has enough for the first down before he got tackled around the legs by Ryan Vance.
Again, the two guys that played here before him, there was a lot more design quarterback run, but Spencer Rattler is very athletic. I mean, he has excellent feet and can turn plays with his feet. They just don't call design runs for him as much as they did for Kyler Murray or Jalen Hurts.
Plenty of time for Rattler. Now flush to his right. Another throw on the run. That's Mayfield-esque. Catch by Mims. To the Cyclone 37-yard line they go with another first down on a 20-yard pickup.
See, his arm talent is so good, he doesn't have to have his feet in perfect position. And he can still get that over a defender to a receiver. I mean, there aren't many guys in college football that can make that throw.
To know how to layer it in the way he just did was unbelievable.
We've seen that a few times today. Back to Ramondre Stevenson.
It's been fun to watch him today, too. He's so much more confident than he was earlier in the year. I think getting benched against Texas was one of the best things that happened to him. He kind of regrouped, maybe had, you know, some humility and came back in. And since then, he has played lights out.
You know, it's interesting because when we talked to him on the phone, he didn't call it a benching. He called it a timeout. He knew that he was going back in the game, never felt like he was not going back in the game.
And he played great when he did. He's going for another touchdown. Some bumping, and it's incomplete. Trajan Bridges, playing in his first game of the season, off suspension today, couldn't come down with a touchdown catch.
We had a step. There is some bumping, and it's a beautiful throw by Rattler. I mean, you can't put it in a better spot if you're the quarterback. Bridges just not able to haul it in.
He's a sophomore, five-star recruit, really a backup player last year, had seven catches, was a special teams player. He's been practicing all season. He was very frustrated that his suspension turned out to be longer than Stevenson's and Perkins. Quite communicative about that on Twitter. I was going to say vocal. Can you be vocal on Twitter if you're not speaking?
Oklahoma.
Don't think so.
First time out of the half.
Timeout called by the Sooners. No scoring by either team here in the third, although this one was close. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear, from end zone to end zone. Goodyear more driven. Partly cloudy day outside AT&T Stadium. Little cool inside. The roof is closed, but the doors are open to get some airflow. It's 58 degrees outside. Rattler is sacked on third down and seven, and that's big because that takes Oklahoma out of field goal range. Will McDonald with the sack.
Well, he's led the team with sacks. He has benefited from the year that Bailey's had, working on the left tackle Swenson, and just uses that speed rush to get around the big left tackle. On the backside of Rattler, Rattler not able to get away.
And for Will McDonald, that is 9.5 sacks, the single season Iowa State record. The redshirt sophomore from Pewaukee, Wisconsin. He shared the record coming in with Dale Pearson and Sean Moorhead. So Munchaw punts again, hangs it very high, almost scraped the bottom of that massive big screen. Top of the field here at AT&T Stadium.
Well, this Oklahoma defense, this was when they played in Ames, and this was the problem that they had early in the year. Brock Purdy threw some balls up, and they didn't come down with interceptions. They just knocked them to the ground. That happened two or three times in the game earlier this season. Now today, a different story. Brock Purdy puts it in a bad spot. Oklahoma comes away with the ball. That was the interception by Norwood. This was the interception by Pat Fields. A different deal today for Brock Purdy. He'll take some chances, and Oklahoma making him pay for it today.
Sy Alex Grinch, the defensive coordinator, he told us yesterday turnovers will be the biggest factor in this game, and they have been huge. Charlie Kohler stumbles ahead. And what a turnaround. At the beginning of the year, they couldn't get a takeaway. They couldn't get any last year. They had 11 all season. Only four teams in all of college football had fewer. They still made it to the college football playoff.
And that was kind of his trademark, too, in other places he'd been, you know, taking the ball away. That's what he prided his defenses on, and they weren't able to do it until just recently.
They have 12 interceptions this year. That's more than their entire takeaway total in 14 games last year. Breece Hall, as we approach 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, gets to the 24. Delarian Turner Yell made the tackle. Another thing that Coach Grinch has done, the front gets all the attention, and they've been terrific. But he said, we decided a lot of our guys in the secondary are relatively the same from a talent standpoint, so we're just going to play more people and hope that they're fresher at the end of the games. And that's happened as well. Tane Nwangu is the running back now on second and six. Xavier Hutchinson across midfield, still on his feet, and finally twisted down at the 34. Amazing run after the catch by Hutchinson.
Nifty little play because they shifted this tight end out. It was a late shift, and that was Chase Allen who got the block, and then Hutchinson with the yards after the catch. Nice call by Tom Manning.
42-yard play. Nwangu's still the running back. He stopped after a short pickup.
He's a fifth-year senior, one of the team leaders. This guy refused to go down.
Yeah, he's a big guy, very strong after the catch, 6'3", 207 pounds. Having a heck of a ball game tonight.
Accustomed to the yards after contact. He had a 65-yard touchdown in the regular season game against Oklahoma, which was his first as a Cyclone. Under 2.5 to go in the third quarter. Breece Hall, can he get away from Trey Norwood? No, nice play by the redshirt junior. Missed all of last year with a knee injury. And he's another reason they're better this year.
Absolutely. I mean, the return of Ronnie Perkins after the 5-game suspension and the return of Trey Norwood from the injury, and the more he plays and the more he's in the rotation. He was a corner originally. Now he's playing safety or nickel, and he has really impacted the back end of this defense.
Among those with whom he's tied, Mike Rose, the linebacker for Iowa State. Big third down here. And they convert. Charlie Kohler to the 21-yard line.
Very comfortable and confident in Kohler, particularly on third down, particularly in the red zone. Very dependable guy. Boxed out there. You know, you imagine he did a lot more rebounding than shooting when he played with Trey Young.
It looks like it.
He knows how to box out those football defenders. Avail himself to the throw. Purdy. Kohler, nice leaping catch at the 5-yard line. First and goal, Cyclones.
How did he get so open? This has to be some kind of a breakdown in the Oklahoma coverage. You don't let a 6'6 main target get this wide open on the sideline. And Purdy gets him the football.
Breece Hall. Can he run away from Pat Fields? He lunged for the pylon. Did not get in. Larry and Turner Yell came over to help Fields. Out of bounds. 53 seconds to go, and they rewind the clock now.
When we take a look at the Dr. Pepper pylon cam, you can see Hall reaching for it. And Turner Yell coming to hit him right before he gets that ball to the edge.
It's disappointing anytime you reach for a Dr. Pepper and you can't get one. Trying to make a game of it as we head to the fourth quarter. Hall runs into traffic, flagged down at the line of scrimmage, thrown by the official along the near sideline.
I'm just wondering if the left tackle was lined up in the backfield, Sean Foster. It'd be interesting to see what this call is going to be.
Offside. Defense, number 7, line up the neutral zone. Half the distance, we're playing second down.
Well, actually, he was on the line, and Ronnie Perkins, who was lined up over him, was offside. And I was looking at it, and it seemed like one of them was out of position. It was Perkins. There you go. You see the head over the nose of the football.
Oh, it's trying to get an edge.
So it's second and goal, about a foot from the end zone.
I'd be surprised to see a fake and a keep by Brock Purdy.
Hall!
Another
way
flag
up
down
into the air. There is another flag down thrown by the official on the far sideline this time. He threw his hands up in the air, the same official who threw the flag indicating touchdown. So I think it's going to be against Oklahoma, if I had to guess.
I'm sorry. What a defense. That penalty is a touchdown.
Two plays in a row. Oklahoma lines up offsides. Breece Hall is going to go airborne for this touchdown. Up and over, and I'll tell you what, we got to show this block by Charlie Kohler after the kick, because it was a devastating takeout block on Pat Fields.
He's become a better blocker as he's gotten bigger and stronger. Coaches talk about he wants to be a good blocker. Extra point good. And Breece Hall has now scored a rushing touchdown in 11 straight games, which is the school record.
Watch this block now. This is a big man with a full head of steam. He comes over and just takes out Pat Fields. I loved how Tom Manning called it as we take a look at it from the Dr. Pepper pylon cam. Breece Hall getting way up over the top. And Iowa State fighting to get back in this football game now, down 10.
You mentioned the school record. We talked to Matt Campbell, Tom Manning, the offensive coordinator yesterday about Breece Hall. But so much of their success there is the culture, the buy-in. It's about effort every day, doing all the right things all the time. When Breece Hall first got there, he didn't practice very hard. And Coach Campbell said, we're going to redshirt you, you know, unless you get along with the program here and practice.
Right.
So he started to practice better. They put him in a game, and he's been the starting running back ever since.
Yeah.
And he is a much better practice player, the coaches tell us.
And he decided to be roommates with Brock Purdy and Mike Rose, which has been really important for him because those two guys understand the process. They know about the preparation, and he has really learned from them.
Charlie Kohler told us nobody loves football more than Brock Purdy. Fair catch by Trey Brown of the Drake Nettles kickoff. Here's Kevin Negandhi. It's a 10-point game now. Jaden Hazelwood dropped by Daytron Young. That'll be the final play of the third quarter. Quarter in which Oklahoma did next to nothing on offense. They're still up 10. Back after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Back in Arlington, Texas, and on our way to the fourth quarter in this Dr. Pepper Big 12 championship game. Iowa State making its first appearance in the 25-year history of this conference. Oklahoma 10-1 all time in conference title games in the Big 12. And they've won 13 titles in all. For several years, the regular season champion was the conference champion. They didn't play a championship game. Spencer Rattler. On second and 7, has a man open and finds him out near midfield. It's Braden Willis, the tight end, with his first catch of the day.
Well, you just can't give Spencer Rattler that much time. It's a 4-man rush, and he just kind of buys more and more time. It's hard to hold coverage that long, and he was patient enough to wait till he saw an opening.
21-yard gain. Oklahoma had just 38 yards of offense in the third quarter. They punted three times. Rattler belted after he threw it, and then his receiver, Stevenson, got blasted by Lawrence White. Well, it was Will McDonald who reintroduced himself to Spencer Rattler.
It started with the pressure from Will McDonald. He forced him out of the pocket. Then he gets the hit, and Lawrence Wright reads the play on the throwback to Stevenson and is there for a solid tackle against a big running back. He's given up about 45 pounds in weight to Stevenson.
TJ Pledger in at running back now. Rattler faked it to him, then shovels it forward, and it's an incomplete pass. Mike Rose made that play happen a little bit faster than Oklahoma had anticipated. And here come the Cyclone fans imploring their defense for a big stop.
Iowa State choosing to bring pressure that time. Mike Rose forces the bad shuffle. And Oklahoma, even though they're up 10, they are 1-for-8 on third down in the ballgame.
The two turnovers, the big difference in the game. Rattler, they bring pressure at him. He has a nice pocket and fires, and it's incomplete. Broken up by Anthony Johnson, intended for Theo Weiss.
Anthony Johnson is their best cover corner. And he was in good position on Weiss and was able to knock the ball out on the sideline. Oh, Iowa State brings pressure. It's a good enough pocket. It's a good throw. But Anthony Johnson knocks the ball loose.
Flag down.
False start. Offense. Number 4. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
And we've heralded Lincoln Riley for his play calling, deservedly so. You know, every opposing coach we talk to talks about what a great play caller he is. My question would be, you know, with this relatively big lead in the second half, 3 carries for Ramondre Stevenson in the second half? Munshaw hangs it up high. Fair catch made by Tariq Milton. What an early holiday gift this is for college football fans. It's Championship Saturday starting here in Arlington, Texas. Next, we'll go to Charlotte for the ACC matchup between Clemson and Notre Dame. Their regular season meeting, one of the best games of the year.
It really was. It was a great game. Lots of fun plays, overtime. Notre Dame really kind of proved their mettle in that game. But Clemson was without Trevor Lawrence. They were without James Skalski and 2 other starters on that defense. I think it'll be a different situation and a different Clemson football team tonight.
You'd have to think if Clemson wins, they're both get into the college football playoff. If Notre Dame wins, that would probably knock Clemson out. With 2 losses, no 2-loss team has ever gotten in to the top 4. On first down, it's a short completion of Tariq Milton, tackled by Trey Norwood. And a score here would really make things interesting in the house that Jerry Jones built.
Who else can make a play for Iowa State? Kohler's made some plays. Of course, Breece Hall's making plays. Hutchison has made plays. Who else can come up and make a big play, a chunk play, for this Cyclone offense?
They brought Nwangu in motion. Purdy is belted down back at the 17-yard line. Or at the 13-yard line. Pardon me, Nick Benito and Brian Asamoah.
Well, here's Benito again. It's just his quickness. Just too quick for the left tackle. Sean Foster gets low, gets in there. Asamoah beats the guard. And this defense that leads the Big 12 in sacking the quarterback makes its presence felt again.
And for so long, especially in recent years, it was the offense of Oklahoma carrying the defense. That is no longer the case. This is a top 20 defense in the nation. Much better than that in many categories. Purdy managed to get away from Winfrey. Throws over the middle, caught, but way short of the first down is Jirell Brock. About 5 yards short of the line to make.
It's about the 3rd time that Winfrey has had the quarterback like in his grasp.
And near the end zone or in the end zone too.
And not able to get him on the ground. I mean, and again, that's the knack I think that Brock Purdy has. He has the ability to get away from pressure, and you can see Winfrey can't believe it.
But this defensive front, it is so different from what we're used to seeing from Oklahoma. I mean, talk about Ronnie Perkins, Winfrey, Nick Benito.
Good punt by Rivera here. And Marvin Mims makes the fair catch. Well, the word Alex Grinch used is disruptive. He said in the past our defensive line just seemed akin to do their job, be in the right place. Now they're disruptive. All All right, Kevin, I want to ask Todd about that in a moment.
Right now it should be Ramondre Stevenson time.
They faked it to him. Jeremiah Hall leaping over a would-be tackler who tried to chop him down. And Jeremiah gets the first down to the 50-yard line.
Very valuable part of this offense. Does a little bit of everything. Run blocking, pass catching. Lincoln Riley says, I don't think he's great at anything, but he's pretty good at everything. And they use him in a lot of ways.
First team all conference. Only two players on the offense. Center Humphrey the other. Nobody on the defense. That clearly motivated several of them today. Here's Stevenson again. I do want to ask you about Ohio State.
Yep.
You know, some people seem to think they haven't played enough games. You know, they're going to play six games. Other teams in consideration for the college football playoff will have played 10, 11, whatever it is. Do you think it's not just good enough for them to win today?
No, I don't think it's good enough for them to just win. I think they need to win impressively because I don't think their resume, in my eyes, is good enough yet. They have one win over a ranked opponent, a good team, Indiana. Everybody else they played, sub-500 teams. And I just don't know that they have enough body of work or resume without an impressive win tonight or today.
In the committee's charter, you know, we went through the exercise. 1 year isn't supposed to carry into the next. Each team should be viewed as a new team. But you wonder if this Ohio State team's benefiting from what the recent teams have done. Here's a big play on third down and 8. Stevenson stacked up. That's an interesting play call. On third and 8, a run up the middle. Jake Hummel and Orion Vance made the stop. And
Lincoln Riley's playing situational football right now. He says, I know my defense is playing outstanding. Yes, it's only a 10-point game, but if we keep playing field position and let our defense make them go a long field, we're going to be okay. And plus, the longer the clock runs, it's a two-score game, the harder it is for Iowa State.
There's Munshaw on again. His fourth punt of the second half. Tariq Milton makes the fair catch. Oklahoma can't knock them out. Iowa State can't make the play that really gets them back in. The College Football Playoff Committee watching today's action with great interest.
The Dr. Pepper Big 12 Football Championship game on ABC is brought to you by Ice Cold Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville. In part by Pacific Life, more than 150 years strong. Trust in your tomorrow. And Capital One, what's in your wallet?
Oklahoma still leads by 10. They were up 24-7 at the half. It's 24-14. They've punted five times and have not scored here in the second half, but the defense has yielded just one touchdown in this half to Iowa State. The Cyclones from their own 13, and they're still at the 13 as Breece Hall was stopped by Brian Asamoah.
You know, Sean, last year we had Oklahoma in the College Football Playoff, and coming into that game, their defensive numbers were pretty good. I mean, they were ranked as one of the best teams defensively in the Big 12, but I didn't think offenses were all that good in the Big 12 last year. I didn't know if those numbers were legit, and LSU certainly exposed them in that game. This defense this year is different. They are legit, and it starts with their defensive front.
9 minutes to go. Purdy throwing into single coverage, and his receiver, Sean Shaw, could not come down with it in a battle with Trey Norwood.
See, this is a great play by Norwood, but it's Winfrey first with the pressure. Winfrey hits Purdy as he gets rid of the ball. The ball's a little underthrown. Norwood's in there fighting. Again, the combination of the work by the front and the improved work of the secondary makes plays like that happen.
Cornerback coach Roy Manning has got to be thrilled with the technique there. The ability to get your head turned around at the very end and knock that ball away.
Third down and 10. Pressure again. Open is Charlie Kohler. Tripped up. Across the 30 at the 33. Well, that might have been a really big gainer, but it's a third down conversion they had to have. David Agwebu slow to get up. And Delarian Turner yelled a big tackle in the open field. It's a 20-yard completion.
Well, Alex Grinch is smelling blood in the water. He sends pressure. Watch the toughness of Purdy. He's going to get hit right at the end of that play. Still delivers the strike to Kohler. One-on-one coverage gets the separation. And a huge first down. And that's only their third conversion. They're 3 for 11 now on third downs. They just keep hanging in there, don't they?
Yep. 6 catches for 92 and a touchdown for Kohler. Purdy turned down. Breece Hall in the flat. Comes to the near side instead for a bigger gain to Sean Shaw, an Oklahoma native. First down there at the 48-yard line. Actually, they'll put it down now on the 49. John Michael Terry harassed Purdy, but he survived that rush. Hall thrown down, thrown forward by Brian Asamoah to the 46. 8:10 to go. All three timeouts for Iowa State, 2 for Oklahoma.
And 10 points, 2 scores, so your offensive player of the year in a conference still a factor with Breece Hall coming out for a break right now, but you don't have to abandon your run completely.
He's getting a breather. Jhené Nwangu was the back. He went in motion. Purdy, the quick pop to Tariq Milton. And he stopped about 2 yards shy of the line to gain by Nick Benito. Third down, 2, certainly 4-down territory here.
Well, you're not in field goal range, so it has to be, right? I mean, you need 2 scores. You need a touchdown, a field goal. But you're too far away now.
You think they should also be speeding up the operation
a little bit.
A long time to get these plays in. More than midway through the fourth quarter. Big 12 championship on the line. Brock Purdy throws. Wow. Somehow it got through. 2 Sooners to Chase Allen for a first down at the 37-yard line.
Well, Trey Norwood was trying for his second interception of the game. It's going to be on the left side of the screen. You'll see Chase Allen, and right in between 2 defenders, Norwood going for the interception, and Iowa State gets the first down.
Chase Allen, another huge target, 6'7", 240, the son of Terry Allen, the former Kansas coach, and once an Iowa State assistant coach under Dan McCarney, who's here today. Purdy throws near sideline, and Hutchinson has it. Excellent leaping hands catch for another first down. They're at the 25 and on the move.
We talked about both of these quarterbacks and their ability to make plays out of the pocket, off schedule. Throwing on the move and an incredible effort by Hutchinson.
Clearly a catch. Breece Hall.
I think they're stopping this play to take a look at it.
Which is a break for Iowa State because that play was going nowhere.
Part of the snap of the page for the both. The previous play is under further review. The one on film was a catch.
Now the flip side of that could be Iowa State had Oklahoma on its heels and had some momentum. We'll tell you what the replay booth decides when we come back.
After further review, it was an incomplete pass. It will be second down at the 37-yard line. Please set the game clock to 6:37, please. 6:37.
So a 12-yard gain wiped out. Matt Austin, what do you think?
Yeah, that's a good overturn. He stuck the ball originally, got a foot down, but you can see him going to the ground. The ball is loose there. Just his fingertip touching it. Ball hits the ground. That's definitely an incomplete pass.
So second and 10 from the 37. 6:37 to go. Iowa State has trailed throughout. Xavier Hutchinson
Wow.
That's a catch. That's a first down. Boy, is he tough after the catch. 6'3", 207, and powerful.
And he knew where Trey Brown was, and he was able to turn that back inside. Brown was coming from his outside. He felt him and peeled back inside after the catch to get the first down.
He looks like a running back on the field, and he plays like one after the catch.
From Jacksonville, Florida, his parents were in the Navy. Seventh catch of the day for 91 yards. 6 minutes to go in the Big 12 title game. Purdy pursued again. Dumped it off. Breece Hall inside the 10. First and goal, Iowa State near the 8-yard line.
Just the instincts of Brock Purdy, and guess who was chasing him? Yep, Perrion Winfrey again in the backfield. Pressure from number 8. Purdy feels him, leaves the pocket, and alertly finds Breece Hall.
Breece Hall again inside the 3-yard line. Impressive drive, but time consuming as well. Under 5.5 to go.
If they don't score here, you may want to use one of your timeouts too.
On second and goal, Hall driving toward the end zone for a touchdown.
They fed him the football 10 times in the fourth quarter in the win at Ames. They're feeding it to him again in the fourth quarter here in the Big 12 championship game.
Second touchdown of the game. The extra point by Connor Asali is good from 17 down to within 3.
You got 3 guys here, all 6'6 and well over 200 pounds. And Breece Hall gets right in into that little vortex and takes it into the end zone.
19 rushing touchdowns, 3 behind the nation's leader, Najee Harris of Alabama. Back at the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship, Breece Hall's second touchdown of the game has brought the Iowa State Cyclones within 3. 5:15 to go. They were twice down by 17 points.
Remember, Trey Brown already one huge kickoff return in this ball game.
They've struggled to cover kicks from time to time this year, including that 43-yarder by Brown late in the first half. Here he comes again. Trey Brown, another big return. And great starting field position for the Sooners at their own 44. Here's Kevin Negandhi. Thank you, Kevin. Here, 5 possessions, 5 punts, just 82 yards of offense in the second half. And maybe that kickoff return will bring the offense to life. 42-yard return. He had a 43-yarder to set up a score late in the first half. Stevenson buried for a 1-yard loss. Orion Vance and Jake Hummel.
I think it's time to get aggressive.
Well, and I think it's the reason is I think Iowa State is going to be aggressive on defense. They're going to try to bring pressure. They're going to try to crowd the line of scrimmage. They're going to leave some one-on-one opportunities to throw the football.
Stevenson just 14 yards rushing in the second half. Had 67 at the break. 3-man rush. Rattler on target. Beautiful throw to Braden Willis. And a first down for Oklahoma to the 42 of Iowa State.
That's called threading the needle. I mean, there were 4 Iowa State defenders in the area. It was zone coverage. And Spencer Rattler just threw it right into an open window, and it wasn't a very big window.
Big play by Braden Willis back in his hometown of Arlington, Texas. 15-yard completion. Back to the run. Stevenson with running room and a first down at the 30-yard line. And they're in field goal range for Berkich at the very least with 4 minutes to go on the clock running.
Boy, Creed Humphrey, their center, the leader, the veteran. Outstanding block on that play. Really does a great job of using his leverage, his body, and moving people.
On first and 10, Stevenson avoided some blitzing traffic. And now you wonder if Matt Campbell will start thinking about using his timeouts on defense. It's much easier to control the clock when you're on offense.
Yeah, he may need to. And again, I mean, how costly have those two kickoff returns been to his team? Right before the half, that led to another score that put him down 17. And now, right now, when you crawl back into the game and you trail by three, Oklahoma with a lot of momentum and field position to be aggressive.
Rattler looked to the left. He saw single coverage out there, and he finds Willis. What an effort to get the first down to the 20-yard line. They did their best, did those Cyclones, to knock him back, but he's a powerful 6'3", 236.
With the absence of Stogner, it's forced Braden Willis and Jeremiah Hall to kind of carry the load, and that was a heck of a play by Braden Willis, refusing to go down, knowing what he needed to get for the first down.
And now you have to use your timeouts.
Yeah, they will have to, certainly after this next play. You don't want to do it now that you left the play clock go this far. They're at the 20. Single coverage outside again. It's Stevenson. Faked it to him, and it's Rattler thrown down. And here comes the first timeout called by Matt Campbell.
I tell you, I'm so impressed with what Spencer Rattler did there. First of all, he let the play clock go all the way down.
First time out of the half.
And then when he ran the football, he was aware to not go out of bounds, to go down in the field of play, continue the clock running, and then force the timeout to be called. Watch this at the end. He knows stay in bounds, get down. Right there. It's very smart heads-up play by the quarterback.
And a good call, too, by Lincoln Riley. You know they're going to, on the defensive side for Iowa State, load up on Ramondre Stevenson.
Right.
Rattler family's here. Dad Mike, Mom Sue, sister Olivia. Spencer told us that his dad is still his, as he said, biggest coach.
Yep.
Then he quickly said, other than Coach Riley. But his dad has coached him his entire life, and he's done a terrific job.
Talks to him a couple times a week, and Spencer said, you know, he talks to me about being organized, making sure all my stuff is organized. My house is clean. He gets a haircut every week, get a fresh haircut every week. Feels like if he feels clean and organized, it's going to help the way he plays on the field. He's played well tonight.
Second and 10. 2:19 to go. Two timeouts for each team. Rattler again. Rattler. We've passed some traffic. Got swung down by Greg Eisworth, the fifth-year senior. First team all Big 12 for the third year in a row.
It's called their second time out of the half.
One of the players who helped turn this around. And think about what it was like when he first got here.
Yeah.
And what it is like now.
This is Mike Rose, the conference defensive player of the year that Spencer Rattler kind of makes miss and adds some yardage to that play before the tackle by Eisworth.
So a big third down and 5 here.
And if Lincoln Riley, if you'd have told him you would be winning in the fourth quarter 24-21 and be 1-for-10 on third down, probably wouldn't have believed you. And that is not very good for this Sooner offense. Credit to the Iowa State defense, but no bigger third down play than this one right here.
The offense stagnant here late in the year, 264 yards of offense in the win against Baylor last week, the lowest of the Lincoln Riley era.
I think part of that, though, was the fact that there was so much disruption in their schedule. They had their game against West Virginia canceled twice and only one game in 28 days.
Well, it's about winning, and this is a play to take a big step toward victory if they can convert on third and five. Plenty of time for Rattler. Throws to the end zone, incomplete. Intended for Jaden Hazelwood. The Sooner sideline wants a flag, and I don't think they're going to get it. Lawrence White had the coverage. So here comes the field goal team. An enormous stop for Iowa State. Even with a field goal, it's still a one-score game.
Well, and not only is it a great stop, but because it was an incomplete pass, it stops the clock, and Iowa State able to save their last timeout.
So here's Berkich. One for two today. Made a career-long 54-yarder. This to force Iowa State to score a touchdown. 32 yards, good. 27-21. But the dream is still alive for Brock Purdy. Visited places like Boise State and Alabama and Texas A&M, but he was captivated by Matt Campbell and his staff. Said, I wanted to go someplace and build something and do things that they've never done before. And they've never won an outright conference championship at Iowa State ever.
Yep.
A chance to do it now. I mean, it's a kind of been a magical season. It's just the ending waiting to be written.
Yeah, and if you're a guy like Brock Purdy who loves football the way he does, and these are the kind of things you dream about. You know, when you're playing out in the street or out in the backyard and you're pretending to be an announcer, you put yourself in these kind of situations if you're a quarterback. You know, this much time on the clock, I got one timeout. We're one score away. A touchdown can win the Big 12 championship for us. You couldn't ask for a better situation if you're Brock Purdy.
.201 to go, one timeout. Well, kickoff returns have been huge. They're lined up like they're going to onside kick this, and they fake it.
Just to mess up the return setup a little bit. A little trickeration that time by Shane Beamer, Lincoln Riley.
Oklahoma, the two big kickoff returns to set up scores today. It was Iowa State, an 85-yard kickoff return in the regular season game from this man, Tane Nwangu. Tane Nwangu tripped up at the 30 on a huge tackle by Robert Barnes. So 70 yards to go for the first conference title since 1912. The only other one was in 1911. Neither one of them was an outright title. Iowa State was alone atop the regular season standings this year in the Big 12 at 8-1. Oklahoma right behind them. But it is the winner of the championship game that is the champion. Looked like Oklahoma was offside, and there is a flag down. Perkins got to Purdy. But it looked like the Sooners were a bit premature across the line.
Yeah, I think Nick Benito, number 11, was clearly across the line. It's going to negate this sack. And this defense has three sacks today, two interceptions off of Brock Purdy. That time a little anxious on first down.
Offside defense, number 11, interrupted right at the snap. 5-yard penalty, replay. First down. The clock will start on the snap with the foul under 2 minutes. Police says the game clock to 150, please. 150.
The problem for Iowa State, though, is even though they got the penalty and Brock Purdy wanted to take advantage of a free play, they are having trouble blocking Perrion Winfrey, and he is hitting him on the inside.
Two fourth quarter comebacks against Oklahoma and Texas. This is the only time they've ever beaten those two powerhouses in the same year. Part of this magical season. Dumped off in some running room. Xavier Hutchinson runs out of bounds just shy of midfield near the 48-yard line. First and 10. Iowa State, they'll put it back at the 47.
Nice call by Tom Manning, anticipating pressure. It was a quick throw and a crossing route, which you run against man coverage. And Hutchinson with another big play tonight.
Got out of bounds to stop the clock. There's Tom Manning. offensive coordinator, longtime friend of Matt Campbell. They were college teammates at Mount Union, where they learned a lot about winning. Purdy checks it down to Breece Hall. Short game, but they're to midfield, maybe even the 49. Official hasn't spotted the ball yet. They'll put it at the 50. 3-yard pickup.
Still in need of a chunk play. They've got good field position. They've got one timeout, but they need a touchdown.
Certainly enough time with the timeout. Well, the rising stars in coaching. He's not rising anymore. He's a star. Matt Campbell, Big 12 Coach of the Year for the third time in 4 years. Purdy. High throw caught by Hutchinson. His helmet comes flying off. And they throw a flag. It was a 1 yard gain to Sean White. In on the tackle. And that offense, that defensive line looks tired now. They've been running after Purdy all day. Not as much pressure here lately.
It's the same play that they ran to the other side.
Well, that's Deshaun, a face mask.
Yeah, that's sure. That's clearly a face mask. And it was a good defensive play.
Face mask grabbing the helmet opening. Defense. 15-yard penalty. They're great. They're remaining in the game due to the foul pulling off the helmet. First down.
Give Purdy a lot of credit, too. He's been hanging in there with pass rush all over him all day long. And he's just shown presence in the pocket and also the ability to stare down the gun barrel and throw the ball knowing that he's going to get hit.
If I'm Oklahoma right now on this play, the guy that I, even though Hutchinson has made a ton of big plays, the guy I'm going to pay attention to where he is right here, 88, Kohler. This is the part of the field where Brock Purdy looks for him.
Purdy pressured again this time. Gets away, running out of time. Dodges another defender. Throws down the field, incomplete. Trying to get it to Chase Allen. And Delarian Turner Yell had the coverage.
Beautiful play by Turner Yell. I mean, first of all, Brock Purdy continues this knack of being a magician, eluding free rushers.
He gets away.
From Isaiah Thomas and then makes the throw, but watch the play by Turner Yell at the end. Just fights that ball out. That's an incredible offensive play by Purdy and a defensive play by Turner Yell, thanks to the Dr. Pepper pylon cam for that shot.
1:18 to go. Iowa State driving, down by 6. They were down by 17.
They
moved.
Like
the right side of the offensive line moved.
Yep, sure did. It's going to be 2nd and 15.
What dramatic twists and turns down the stretch in this conference championship game.
False start, offense, number 55, 5-yard penalty. Still 2nd down.
Darrell Simmons. This line has battled the outstanding Oklahoma D-line all day. So the ball goes back to the 38, 1:18 to go, one timeout for the Cyclones. Brock Purdy, 2 costly interceptions earlier. They won't remember those in Ames if he can get them in the end zone on this drive.
There's movement again. This time it's a left tackle, Sean Foster. There was motion, and so it was a long snap count, and the left tackle moved.
False start, offense, number 75, 5-yard penalty, still.
Another fifth-year senior, Foster, who was here before the program turned around.
Well, now, obviously, if you're Brock Purdy here, you just got to think about some productive plays here. You're obviously 4-down territory from here on out. You don't have to get all of this 20 back in one play.
And there, you better hurry up. Play clock down to 10.
They want to waste a timeout.
Down to 3 as Purdy takes the snap. Out wide to Hutchinson. Nice call.
Yep.
They get about 10 yards back and get out of bounds. Again, the play clock winding down.
Kohler and Hutchinson, those are the two guys.
Well, you can't waste your time out with the clock stopped.
No, they're a mess.
They're going to have to do it. They just do snap it. Didn't look like anybody moved. Purdy, can he rescue this? Purdy lofts it up. Jump ball, and it is intercepted by Trey Brown. Another huge play by the senior from Tulsa. And another critical mistake by Purdy. And you have to put some of that on the sideline. It was a fire drill.
Yeah, this started off poorly. You don't want to waste the timeout, but you probably should have taken it here. Deshaun White with the quick pressure, and Purdy just not able to get enough on that football. And it fluttered up in the air, and Trey Brown with the third interception of the football game for Oklahoma. Again, what's the difference in this Oklahoma team on defense? Their front and their secondary getting takeaways now.
Trey Brown, really the player of the game for them. His two kickoff returns were enormous and momentum turners and set up scores. And Brock Purdy, such a great competitor, tried to do too much there. And again, the length of time it took to get that play in.
Yeah.
Is something Matt Campbell and his staff will be kicking themselves about for a long time. So unless a disaster strikes the Sooners, this will be their sixth straight conference championship. In the previous five, more often than not, almost always it was the offense carrying the defense. It's the other way around right now for Oklahoma. The quarterback comparison, Rattler and Purdy. And Alex Grinch told us yesterday, turnovers. That's the whole game as far as I'm concerned.
Yep.
Turnovers. His defense took it away three times on three picks thrown by Purdy. And Oklahoma did not turn it over all today.
And Trey Brown is one of the fastest players in college football, but he always struggled with takeaways. And now he gets his third interception, and it seals the game.
So Iowa State has taken some major steps forward, but this one will hurt for a while. They fought valiantly but couldn't finish the comeback, and Oklahoma is the Big 12 champion for the sixth year in a row and for the 14th time in the 25-year history of this conference. Texas next most with three. That's how much the Sooners have dominated the Big 12. They've won six straight conference championships for the first time since the 70s and 80s, when Chuck Fairbanks and Barry Switzer led them to those titles.
Sean, take a look at somebody on this interception. Now, we talked about Deshaun White getting the pressure, okay? Here's Deshaun White. He's going to get the pressure. But watch Nick Benito. He's going to be the spy, and he's going to end up being the guy that puts the hit on Purdy that prevents Purdy from really getting enough on this football. He gets away from Deshaun White, but here comes Benito, and that's why that ball fluttered, because Benito's hustle play, and Trey Brown gets the interception.
And Purdy on the scramble, I think that's one. If he had to do it over again, maybe you'd throw away, but you're running out of plays.
Yeah.
You're running out of time. And you wonder if his decision making might have been a little bit better too had it not been for the hurried nature of the play. Spencer Rattler. I wouldn't be surprised if he's the next Oklahoma quarterback who's a number one pick.
Very well
in the
could
NFL
be.
Draft. That seems to be somewhere down the road for him.
He is a talent, and you know, he played so well under control, with composure, within the scheme. I was very impressed with that part of his game today.
Time for a photo opportunity. Wonder if they have enough space on the walls in their beautiful football building. And
they'll build a new building if they need to.
Lincoln Riley, 4 years as head coach. Four conference championships, and he's been there for all six of these in a row. He was the offensive coordinator for the other two. What a great start to this championship Saturday. Oklahoma beats Iowa State 27-21. For immediate post-game coverage of the trophy presentation, log on to ESPN 3 and the ESPN app. Now for Allison Williams, Todd McShay, Todd Blackledge, and our great crew, Sean McDonough, sending you back to the studio.
Boy, that was good.
Trey Brown, player of the game.
Yeah.
We welcome you to post-game coverage of the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship and the Big 12 Trophy Ceremony about to come your way in just a matter of moments. An exciting conference championship game. Trey Brown, the hero, his interception in the final moments stopped a comeback by Iowa State. Reserved the 6-point win. He also had two long kickoff returns that were key. We're ready for the trophy presentation. Down to the field we go. Here's Allison Williams.
Thank you so much. It is time to hand out some hard-earned hardware in a season that has been unlike any other. Congratulations to the Oklahoma Sooners on winning the Big 12 Conference Championship. The first trophy we'll present is to the most outstanding player of the game, quarterback for Oklahoma, Spencer Rattler. Spencer, congratulations. This took a ton of effort just to get to this point and then to get this win today. What did your team have to overcome this season to stand here as champions? Champions, given everything you guys went through to get here.
You're actually playing, especially with my guys. This isn't for me, it's for everybody out here. And the whole team, you know, got this, you know. And we work hard every day to get to this point, and we're here and we did it.
Thank you, Spencer. Congratulations. Now to present the trophy to the Oklahoma Sooners, here is Big 12 Commissioner Bob Boolsby.
Congratulating Coach Matt Campbell and the Iowa State Cyclones on an outstanding year.
And wish them good luck in the postseason. Let's try that one more time. It's too important. First of all, please join me in congratulating the Iowa State Cyclones and Coach Matt Campbell on an outstanding season and wish them well in the postseason. And now it is my pleasure on behalf of the Big 12 Conference to present this year's championship trophy to Coach Lincoln Riley and the Oklahoma Sooners. Coach, you know how this trophy works. Hoist it up there.
Your team fought so hard throughout the course of this game. Iowa State did as well. What enabled them in the end and your defense to come away with this win?
Well, that's speed D for you. they came up big for us all year. And, you know, really fitting that a senior there, Trey Brown, would end it. He did the same thing just across the way against a team we don't like very much in the Cotton Bowl. So he ended both of them here. Very fitting ending, great game. Hats off to Iowa State. You know, this is what the Big 12 Championship should be like.
This was such a challenging season in so many different ways. After the difficult start for your team, how did they overcome everything to stand here as Big 12 champs?
This team and this program have a championship DNA. We call it OU DNA, and that's not just when things are going well. And it takes everybody, it takes belief, but that's just our program. We're never going to back down. And you know, they're 0-2 in the conference. Not a lot of people believed in us, and now we're holding that thing for the sixth time in a row.
Six times in a row, that's pretty incredible. What does it mean to you to be able to have that kind of sustained success year in and year out?
Now, the consistency is important to us because I think any team can have one great year here and there, but being able to do it each and every year, do it at a high level on the biggest stages, it means the world. So proud of this group.
Speaking of doing things at a high level on the biggest stage, Spencer Rattler, your quarterback, with a tremendous performance. What sort of growth have you seen from him this year?
Yeah, he was hungry. You know, he was ready to play this game. You know, I love the way that he approached all of it. And our team came in on edge. And, you know, I think he did a great job handling this environment, you know, for the first time, and a lot of bright years ahead.
Lincoln, thank you so much for the time. Congratulations to the Oklahoma Sooners, your 2020 Big 12 champs.
Thank you for watching post-game coverage of the Dr. Pepper Big 12 Championship Trophy Ceremony. So long from Arlington, Texas.